that a hero lies in you. The fact that you're here means that you're really curious about what we do. You're going to watch Antano and me discuss about how you can launch your legacy and our offerings to help you do that.
So, hi, Harini. What is this entire business of legacy? What do we mean by that?
I believe any individual is a potential of creating a legacy. Because there's so much in every person. There's a backstory to everybody. But when the right set of ingredients come together, when they equip themselves correctly, and when they set up their ecosystem and develop the right set of superior capabilities, then anybody can potentially get on the path to creating a personal legacy.
What is a legacy?
A legacy is something incredible that only that individual can do. It's something that a legacy is born out of something that is so unique to that person. And it's like two people cannot create the same legacy, because what is coming out of that single person is a culmination of all of their life experiences and their creativity and the expertise that they're developing, which takes on a beautiful form that's solving an incredible need in the world today. And that's
so when I think of legacy, I think of Bruce Lee, Michael Jackson, or Amitabh Bachchan. So are you saying that everyone can be like them?
You don't have to be a celebrity to leave a legacy or to launch a legacy. You don't have to be a celebrity to create a legacy, right? I mean, you don't have to be in the field of entertainment, or you don't have to be Albert Einstein or do something along those lines. You could do something so meaningful and unique and create something that's beautiful, that's solving a need in the world. And your impact could be a few hundreds, it could be a few thousands, or it could go across the whole world. So why should everybody be a Michael Jackson or a Steve Jobs?
So you're saying legacy is creating an impact that is meaningful, that only that person could have created based on his or her unique life experiences.
And converting that impact into significance. But I know, why do we tell people that we're going to help you launch a legacy? I mean, why not leave a legacy?
I think leave a legacy kind of looks at it as one thing that you do, and then after that you die, and then there is nothing more you create. I feel like with time compression, when you're able to do things faster in today's era, you don't have to stop with one legacy. Why not one legacy and then the next and then the next?
So you're like creating one life, many legacies.
One life, many legacies. And I think after a point in time, it starts becoming a lifestyle. So when we say launch a legacy, it's a way of living. It's a way of doing business. It's a way of relating to people.
So how did all this begin? I mean, where everything has a start, right?
Yeah.
What was the start to what we're doing?
I think the start of all of this is personal breakthroughs that we help people do, you know, solving impossible situations. Like if you look back at how we started, we helped somebody like Fani Kumar, who was paralyzed, and doctors said he can't move. We helped them overcome that limitation. We helped them regain movements, though it was medically considered impossible. And soon after that, we worked with ARMN's orchestra, where he was helping some underprivileged children for many years. And then we said, give us 6 months and we'll help them be ready for you to launch them. And over a period of time, we realized that this is such a powerful technology. And then we bought it into the personal development space. We help people to achieve their goals. And we found out that it was like using a Ferrari to plow a field. Because when you bring something so powerful into a field like personal development, why limit it to, you know, just overcoming a habit or being more focused or achieving success? The potential and power of the technology is so advanced. Why not create something that is that does justice to how sophisticated and advanced the technology is? And nothing short of legacy justifies the use of this technology to me. So Harini, what is this technology?
Excellence Installation Technology is one where we help people make strategic personal adjustments, not any personal adjustments, very specific kind of personal adjustments that will take them in the direction of a legacy?
What do you mean by strategic? Like, see, someone comes in, they want to change, you help them change. What is so strategic about that?
So out of the million things that you can change, I mean, you don't want everybody to become a clone of somebody who they're looking up to. There's the individuality of every person. So every person's situation in life is unique. Mm-hmm. They have a specific set of limitations. Out of the million capabilities that they can evolve, how do you decide which capabilities they need to evolve at any given point in time? So all of this is arrived at by reverse engineering. Where do they want to be at a larger level? What's their dream? What's, you know, if there were no limitations whatsoever, where would you actually like to be? And in order to make that a reality for you, what should you change in you today? Because where you arrive at is a direct result of who you are. And arriving at those specific strategic set of adjustments that will help you get there, mm-hmm. and implementing it is what Excellence Installation Technology is all about.
Wow, that's great. So it's like each person has an opportunity to achieve something, but they really don't have that opportunity until they change themselves or add a new layer to who they are. And instead of wasting time improving on things they think they need to improve, you're looking at, oh, that opportunity, this person has to become like this. And that's why you call it strategic, because it's not just about how they feel right after they become a new person, it's how, what impact it can have after many years.
Right. And I believe opportunities come and go. I mean, there's so many opportunities around you all the time. Mm-hmm. But the one who's, you know, ready at any point in time to seize those opportunities, the one that wins. And how do you become ready? Is by going after personal development, by evolving yourself, by developing a set of capabilities that will allow you to capture and seize those opportunities that's probably been there all around all the while. But it's only now that you've evolved that you're able to go after and get it.
So, Harini, what is our current legacy?
Our legacy, I believe, is a fascinating, incredibly effective ecosystem, mm-hmm. of people from literally every walk of life, all the way from like 14 years old to like 75, from like a homemaker to an entrepreneur to a serial entrepreneur to a really, really seasoned businessman to professionals and chartered accountants and doctors and change agents and literally everybody who's all knitted together with one purpose of giving back and doing something incredible and evolving their own standards of personal excellence every day. And what these set of individuals do is very effectively use excellence installation technology with each other to continue to evolve the standard of excellence and impact the society at large.
Wow, that's actually a little larger than what I thought our legacy was. I thought our legacy is that we have created an ecosystem that allows for a very personalized one-on-one impact in a group setting. And you're saying it's not just that, it's that and the impact that these people who are being impacted are creating around the world.
Because think about one excellence installation specialist that we create. Mm-hmm. That specialist is not just impacting their own family, but goes on, you know, with every person that they meet and come in contact with. They're not a motivational speaker. They're not somebody who's just professing a bunch of tools and techniques, but they're people whose mere presence is changing lives every day. And how incredibly blessed are we to meet so many people who we are able to equip with the wisdom, the tools, to be able to make such an impact in the society. And to think about it, that's how we started, right? I mean, our entire vision has been generations and generations and generations of excellence.
Wow, that's interesting. You're saying that these are people who are going and they have the wisdom to change people around them so magically, so naturally, that it's creating better families and better societies as a whole. Is that why there are a lot of referrals come as families?
Coming to think of it, I can't think of anybody who's come in who's not brought in their family. I mean, there's been you know, like literally everybody who comes in and who experiences such powerful change, it's impossible to not let your loved ones go through the kind of change that you have. And the fascinating thing about UP and what we do is that there could be 200 individuals out there, there could be 300 individuals out there, but it is an individual experience for everybody, not by chance, but by design.
That's beautiful. Can you explain how is it that a grandmother, a daughter, and a grandson can sit in the same program and they're all experiencing different things? Because you keep repeating it's an individualized experience for each one. And you have like a multi-million dollar business owner and you have a housewife. And in this case, you have a grandmother, daughter, and son sitting in the same program. How is it different experience for all of them?
At the core, the work that we do mm-hmm. is about capability development. And whether it's the grandmother or the grandson or the mother, we're looking at each individual. We do a consultation with every individual in is just, you know, Antano Harini and the person. And we're arriving at what specific set of adjustments must we make in this individual now that's going to give them a butterfly effect in their life, something that's going to radically change the way they look at life, the way they live life, and the kind of results that they're producing in their life. While it's in a group setting, all three of them are together, the specific set of installations that all three of them are experiencing is different based on how we've oriented them before they even come into the program.
So you meet the grandmother one-on-one, and then you meet the grandson one-on-one. You also meet the mother one-on-one. And you give them a list of these are the installations you need to go after. You make your own list of these are the installations we need to make for them. And after the 6 days, you're taking full responsibility to implement them. Or should they go out of the program and then for the next 6 months implement these things?
Well, it doesn't work if I have to give them a set of things that they need to go and implement. I mean, personal change doesn't work like that. Uh-huh. The whole beauty of excellence installation technology is where we do the work for them. We not just arrive at the strategic set of personal adjustments, but we also implement it for them in a way that it feels so natural and innate that after the 6 days, their job is to just go and live life and create experiences, and they're probably going back into the same situation.
Is that how we are different from a training program, that the responsibility for implementation is within those 6 days right. and not after the event?
And that's why we have each event, which is a specialization. Yeah. Like the kind of implementation that we do at an UP event is very different from the kind of implementations that we do at Super Life Directives uh-huh. or at Charisma Intensification. And the important thing is at each stage, you know, so there's no person who's coming back as the same person to another UP event. They come back to another UP event and there's a completely new set of installations we're working on. Because each time you're raising the bar of excellence for that person.
Yeah. So, Harini, when you say installations we're working on, some installations you and I do.
Right.
Some installations are done by the excellence installation specialist. And some installations happen as an outcome of just doing the activities. And the installations that you focus on at UP is on installing certain capabilities.
Right.
And in conversational programming, it's about developing layered relationships and connecting with their family and evolving their ecosystem. What do you do in Super Life Directives and Charisma Intensification?
Super Life Directives and Charisma Intensification is about preparing for your life ahead. I mean, at UP, we ensure that we've pretty much removed the pebbles in their shoes. Mm-hmm. We've helped them create an ecosystem for themselves in a way that they can achieve success on autopilot. And when that becomes a way of life where you're not struggling for time or money anymore, you'll come to a space where you're thinking, what next? I mean, what's that big thing that I want to do in my life? What am I equipped to do with all of my experiences that I've gathered in my life so far? And at Super Life Directives, we bring that together for them and help them experience unbelievably heightened states of creativity and performance, which they can bring back on demand anytime afterwards. Now, it's not possible that I get somebody to experience that tomorrow, But once we put them through the process, because at the end of the day, up can't be explained as anything other than an experiential personal development program. And in fact, all of the membership is about personal development at various layers for different people. And that's why I think, even in the membership, the journey that every individual undertakes is different, is unique, and that's how it is one-on-one and yet in a group. Why do you think, Antano, we created the membership?
It was very simple that there were some people in UP who were experiencing way significant results than the others who were also getting results, but there were some people who were going towards a legacy while some were happy with accelerated success. And when we look back and we saw those people who were about to launch a legacy, they had something in common. They met you and me more often. They after each success, they become a new person. They're able to achieve another level of success. And then when they reach there, they come back to us. And we recognize that there are certain capabilities that they will develop in the next 2-3 years for them to be able to achieve the next level of excellence, the next level of lifestyle. And we look at them and think, instead of the next 2-3 years for this to happen, can we compress that and make it happen in the next 6 months? So we found out that people who are connected and who keep coming back for a consultation more often and a review seem to be getting more from the program. So we thought, why not make it a formal setup and encourage people to keep coming back? And there were some people, when they come back, we noticed that they needed some installations that will help them develop those capabilities in shorter time, but it can't be done at app. It has to be done maybe in a charisma intensification program. So the membership is designed so that we could at each stage help people receive the right kind of installations from the right kind of ecosystem.
And what is so significant about the consultations? What is so amazing about them? I've heard a lot of people talk about consultations. Honey, what is significant about the consultations?
The beauty for me from consultations is it's an accelerated learning for me about each person's industry and business. Because what happens is someone walks into a consultation and they've achieved something, but then there's something that is going on slower than they want it to be. And I don't know anything about their industry, I don't know anything about their business, but by reading into the clues and cues that they are giving unconsciously, I'm able to come to a solution that they haven't thought of. And in doing that, first of all, they are like excited. They've got a solution that might have taken a longer time. And for me personally, I get to learn so many new things, you know. We've worked with so many industries, you know, from investors to bankers to doctors to industrialists to manufacturers to director level people in IT companies to founders of various different startups. And personally, I enjoy that kind of learning because I like to keep myself updated with new things. And when you're solving someone's challenge, you can't solve unless you get to the depth of what they're trying to solve. And the ability to get to it in like 10 minutes, in 15 minutes, although I had know nothing about that industry, fascinates me. It's personally, when I look back after every consultation, I'm like, wow, I'm so happy that I was able to find that. But people come to the consultation because they know, they have seen, they've heard, and some of them have experienced already this happening in their life. And they're like, okay, now let's go to Antano and Harini because they'll have a new way to look at it that'll help us compress time.
So why should somebody take up a membership? Why is it important for an individual? I mean, what is the membership going to give them?
Launch a legacy in 3 years and not 20.
But why in 3 years? What's the hurry? What's wrong in taking a longer time? Because so many times people just like to take a chill and do it slowly. Why not get to a legacy in 20?
Because it's easier to do it in 3 than in 20. Because when things are done right, when you have the right capabilities, when things are going in place, when things are happening, they all fall in place together kind of quick. My route to legacy, which I believe from my own personal experience, is that you have to be extraordinary at something. It's not enough to be good. It's not enough to be great. You got to be extraordinary. And at 21, I published 2 books on technology from the world's second largest publication. And it didn't happen because I was good at programming. It was because people perceived me to be extraordinary at that point in time with programming. And that has to happen. So the way I believe anyone can reach a legacy is they have to invest their time and energy in becoming great learners so that they become extraordinary at what they do. And they need to build an ecosystem of people who'll support them and who'll relate with them. And I feel like the minimum time that's required to do that is about 2 years. And we say within 3 years because so that we could be inclusive of also people who are a little stuck in their life, who haven't started up in their accelerated journey. So within 3 years seems reasonable to me for anyone to be able to launch a legacy.
So you're saying what it takes to launch a legacy is to become an expert at something, to have pretty much solved time crisis and money crisis in their life, and get to a space where they're able to literally, you know, immerse and go on an accelerated path to success. And you're saying that the minimum time that it takes for somebody to find that purpose and to be able to actually deliver and live that purpose is about 3 years, two to three years.
Yeah, now some people might be extraordinary and they might come into the program. There are some of our participants who are geniuses. They've already achieved so many things. The only thing that might be missing in their life could be the ecosystem. You know, people around them will support them. For them, it might take a year. It might take maybe a year and a half. 3 years is keeping an average audience in mind. But with when I say average audience, fairly successful, they're doing good in life, but they want to get to the next level. Now, you might find some people who are coming from a much stuck situation in their life, and you might find some people who are coming from a different level altogether. For them, it may not be 3 years. It might be like a year.
So I know I've heard so many stories of, I mean, I think people have heard of the work that we do as well. And sometimes I get asked, you're working on somebody who you say is, you know, like is paralyzed or, you know, medically impossible condition, or women who've been unable to conceive, who you've helped conceive. And then there are people, you know, who's, you know, who are like a 10 million and 20 million or maybe $100 million business who you've helped them double in like less than a year. And then, you know, you're helping a lot of people literally change their, you know, like their career completely and discover what it is that they want to do, help them become experts and actually start up in a big way and become very successful within a couple of years. And, you're working with like students, you're working with very seasoned entrepreneurs, you're working with people in the middle management and helping them accelerate. Is that like a strategic direction that you're taking?
It totally is. Our long-term vision is to create a technology, an ecosystem. I want to see every child in every school make a choice of what they want to do in life based on what they love to do. Today, the world doesn't work like that. Today, the world works by what they have accidentally equipped themselves to do. If a child wants to become a doctor, but somehow has some irritation in learning names or biological references, she would find it very difficult to become a doctor, and after a few years, she would give up and pursue something else. People today don't make choices based on what they want. They make choices based on what they can. And excellence installation technology empowers people to make choices based on what they want, what they love to do. And I want to make sure that everyone in the world has access to this technology. And so creating an ecosystem where we have people from all kinds of walks of life gives us the environment to develop this technology where it's beyond us. At a point in time, I want people to take the technology to industries, you know, preventive health and education. And this also gives me the environment where I can create specialists who themselves can do incredible work. Like one of our specialists right now, he's helped somebody become a world champion in boxing. And he's specializing in, you know, how to help athletes. Another specialist of ours is helped certain schools achieve 100% pass percentage in rural areas. And each of the specialists are going and creating incredible work, and that's what I'm interested in. I want to create a technology that transforms the world.
Haven't you already created it?
We have created it. Now I want to make sure that it's transforming the world. So Harini, well, tell me about your team. Do they have fun, or are they like launching their legacy, sitting in a corner and then working 24 hours?
I think it's impossible to launch a legacy just being really stuck up.
Yeah.
And having fun and being young and vibrant is, no matter what your age is.
So how do these people have fun? Do they go to parties every night?
I think every moment they're having fun. Uh-huh. There's just an incredible amount of kick and joy and happiness that they get in making a business breakthrough every day. They go out, they're jamming, we're playing music together. And we're feeding off experiences of each other as well. And I think...
That's a great way to have fun, right? Because I think if some people, the only way they know to have fun is go on a vacation or party every night. But I think if you could have fun by innovating, by thinking of great business ideas, and if you can have fun by painting and playing music and each day is filled with laughter, that's a great way to have fun.
And it's not just our team, but it's our extended team of all of our specialists. Uh-huh. And coming to think of it, pretty much every customer. Because, I mean, I'm just incredibly proud of the ecosystem that we've created. Think about it. I mean, there's so many individuals from so many walks of life that come into an UP event. And for some people, taking those 6 days off means, you know, they're putting away revenue to a few millions just in that 1 week, right? And they still make the time to be there at the event because the energy that you experience in that event is not just one of motivation and high, but it's one where there's just so much meaning and you see people transform right in front of your eyes. It's an incredibly rich network of extremely driven individuals.
So Harini, you're telling me that from your own life experience, your team, and the ecosystem and all of what we've been creating is helping people create a legacy, each of them in their own unique way. They're having fun doing that. They're learning to enjoy life. Now, why wouldn't someone be a part of this? Like, who shouldn't be a part of this?
Somebody who's looking at a quick fix or somebody who's, wanting attention in ways without getting into depth of things.
And people are looking for motivation. I tell people, if you're looking for motivation, go watch a movie. If you're motivated and want to do something fast and quick and achieve a legacy, come to us. What is your recommendation to the viewer, Harini? What do you want to tell the viewer?
I would say jump into the bandwagon now. Because it's not, you don't want to miss the bus. You don't want to be too late. It's now, because now's the time. It's an incredible era that we all live in. There's an opportunity to really evolve your personal excellence. And I can tell you from personal experience that there's nothing more satisfying than evolving fast. Because the opportunities that open up when you evolve fast is hard to even put into words. Right? It's something that you have no idea about. I wouldn't have an idea about either. But going after your limitations and fixing them, evolving a set of superior capabilities, creating an environment where you are fascinating yourself every day. I mean, that's how life should be, right? I mean, we all have one life. Yes, a lot of us have so many challenges. Like some of them could seem impossible. Some of them could probably just weigh you down so much. And for some of us, you know, we've accomplished so much and we're at a space where we're thinking, what next? Is this what I want to do for the rest of my life? And no matter where you are, this is the time where there is this technology. We have it here available. There are so many recipients, beneficiaries of Excellence Installation Technology who have each experienced an unbelievable, fast breakthrough in their lives. And this is not like a steroid that you're popping that has a temporary effect. This is one where it's a real investment in yourself. A six-day UP event would give you a new version of yourself. And there's nothing that can buy more happiness than your personal evolution. And being here is the fastest way that I have personally experienced, seen, given the fact that I have traveled around the world, I've done 100 programs, I've seen and I know the market, and I can tell you that there is nothing that actually creates such powerful, targeted, individual change that will empower you to not just change your life and your family and get yourself to the next level, but to literally and really create the kind of impact that you're looking at. And we work right at the core. We work right at the fundamental. We're working on your capabilities. We're working on who you are. We're working on evolving yourself. And this is by far the largest, most effective and premier ecosystem of amazing individuals at various levels that I know and I have created over over all of the years that we've been in the industry doing what we've been doing.
And I think there's some great research going on how to help people live for 130 years. You know, over history, the average life of humans have been increasing with advance in medical technology and science. And there's great amount of research going on how to help someone live for 130 years. And scientists are arguing, billionaires are putting their money in it, arguing that if someone, if a noble person, if a great scientist, instead of in 90 years, if he could live for 130 years, his contribution or her contribution can completely change the world, the way we live in this world. And my proposal is this: what if in the lifetime you already have, you're able to do much, much more than what you would even if you had 130 years? That is what time compression is, and that is the technology we have. And that's why we say one life, many legacies. So I'm curious to see who else is jumping in this bandwagon, and I hope you do.